We just had some figures through. International Phone-In Sick Day is basically a day where workers are encouraged to undermine global capitalism by phoning work and claiming to be unwell. This is sort of the idea of this thing. But we just got some statistics through from the CBI. They've just published their annual report on absenteeism. And last year, among the worst offenders, and there are wide variations now between the job sectors, amongst the worst offenders for absenteeism were Birmingham City Council, Southwest Trains, and astonishingly, Martin McCutcheon. So that seemed like a very odd. Seemed rather strange. And also, the government, and this happened this week, I think, the government announced this week that pubs will soon be open around the clock. Is that good news? Is that a thing that we're glad about? I think so. And it's basically, it's very good news, especially for farmers. As since the foot and mouth outbreak, there's been this huge surplus of pork scratchings available. So it's very, very. Should we try one more foot and mouth joke? And then, all right, we'll just try one more. Okay. Tony Blair today declared that the war against foot and mouth has been won. This is good news, surely. And to commemorate the occasion, farmers and cows came together in a muddy field and played a game of football. That's a lovely. The battle over, a family of cows emerged from an attic where they'd been hiding since it all began. All right, never mind, let's move on. Tonight, on tonight's programme, my friends, we have, and now we're very excited about this, it is heat 3 of our favourite competition on television, Britain's Gayest Man, yeah. And, yes indeed, and it's very interesting because it also coincides with another one of these kind of special, you know, last week it was National Bring Your Daughters to Work Day. Well, this year, and oddly coinciding with the gay theme, it is National Bring Your Gay Friend to Work Day, and we will be celebrating that. And also we have a very, very funny performer, his name is Brendan Burns, and he'll be with us as well this evening. So that's our show for tonight. Let's now begin it. Here we go. Workers of the world, unite! Absolutely. It's Mayday. The news organisations have gone mad. Sky News have described the situation as a disaster because the violence simply hasn't kicked off. Police haven't clashed with demonstrators in an orgy of bloody anarchy with dozens of injured officers and protesters not finding themselves receiving emergency medical attention. Basically, nothing has happened. It has been, it just isn't up to last year's fun. Even McDonald's were prepared, you know. I went into my local McDonald's this morning and they were offering customers an angry meal. So they've absolutely got hold of this riot thing. So it's kind of disappointing when you see them kind of being co-opted and helping out. But however, what we do have for you is an exclusive report. This show will be giving you exclusive coverage of the protest. Our production runner, Jon Morrice, is reporting for us on the protest now. Let's come into Jon. Jon, nice to see you, Jon. Where exactly are you?
I'm in the writer's room.
Right. What's the word on the street? What's happening?
Not much. There's just a bit of a standoff. 5,000 right. People at Oxford Circus waiting to go home.
Do we know what damage has been done today?
Not much. I do think most of the shops are boarded up on Oxford Street.
Right. And have there been any arrests?
Yeah, 31 and counting.
31 arrests?
Yeah.
And do you know what kind of property damage may have been inflicted?
Not at this moment in time, no.
Right. So, we'll just have a look at the situation, John, and see if you can't just give us your assessment of the situation. What's happening now?
They're out to push the temperature up. They want to up the ante.
But as you describe it, basically very large,
Fairly large number of stationary people. Nobody knows what the finale is about.
So, John, you're basically just repeating everything that News 24 is saying.
Protesters have thrown bottles and stones at police.
All right, John, well, we'll come back to you later on in the programme if there are any further developments. We had hoped to bring you some footage of the Mayday protest. We unfortunately were not able to do so. We were in contravention of certain health and safety regulations. So what happened now is our production runner, David Marsh, and I think I may have to stand up, has put together the only exclusive pictures that we can bring you. He's done the riots in the form of a flick book. Should we do it on Ian's camera? Do you need to get nice? But this is David Marsh there. And now let's see, let's look at his work. Very nice work there from David. Very nice. Now, space tourist. Oh, this is a big story. Have you heard about the space tourist? You hear about that? It's a big one. US multimillionaire Denis Tito is now officially the first ever space tourist. He's visiting the International Space Center. I guess they're putting modules together. NASA were hoping to postpone the tycoon's visit till November 2004, when they will have completely installed the gift shop module, but nevertheless, yeah, they got him up there. And what's interesting, and we're very excited about it, is that we've actually got first nibs at a tape that he's made for the Beeb, and here it is.
Like all Americans, I like to work hard and play hard. So with my 2 weeks off, I was looking for something exciting and different. Just as long as I got the chance to relax and kick off my moon boots once in a while. I have to admit I was a little nervous about flying Russian, but once I got used to sucking lunch through a straw, I could just sit back and enjoy the G-force. I was determined to see the sights of space. And legend has it that if you circle the Earth 3 times, you will find love, wealth, and happiness. I realized that even the brochure hadn't prepared me for the many wonders of the space station, and what it might have lacked in atmosphere, it certainly made up for in stuff that floated.
Denis Tito flew from Russian Mission Control in Moscow at a cost of $20 million, but there are some late availability bargains if you prepare to fly from Stansted. Accommodation is restricted at present, so kids will have to stay at home. Dogs and chimps, however, are more than welcome. And if spacewalks are your thing, the tour operator has advised that you bring a loose-fitting spacesuit. The cost of the trip includes return flight, full board, and luncheon vouchers, which can be redeemed in the space station itself or at the salad bar of any Harvester restaurant. But let's leave the last word to Denis Tito.
Cheers, holiday program. From the zero-gravity fun of going to the toilet in my suit to the excitement when our heat shield nearly separated upon re-entry, this was certainly one holiday I never wanted to end, mainly because when I returned, the entire planet had been ravaged by nuclear war, and humans had become slaves to a race of super-intelligent talking apes. Thank you, holiday program, and power be to our simian masters.
Now it's time to welcome, with his unique take on the news, it's RDA correspondent Lionel Blair. Here he is.
Thank you. I'd like to say a couple of words about the anti-globalisation movement. Now, when I started the Mayday riots a couple of years ago, I had no idea it would run out of control like this. You see, it was Richard Attenborough who originally suggested giving a voice to the disfranchised youth of Britain. And I picked up that ball and I ran with it. But now, well, people are getting hurt and property is being destroyed. And I say to all you punks and bikers, crusties and poll tax rioters, enough is enough. Increase the peace and love your brother. Yes, they're fascist pigs. Yes, they crush the poor beneath the jackbooted heels. And yes, the International Banking Confederation is raping the planet like some drunken dockside trawler man taking his frustrations out on a cheap syphilitic written whore. But for my sake, for Dickie's sake, and for your children's sake, look at it from the bank's point of view. I mean, they offer a very competitive interest rate for a personal saver. Trust me, trickle-down economics will work. We just have to give it time. Hey, I'm Lionel Blair. Would I lie to you?